to our channel of Unix Cloud Fusion. So today we are going to answer the two most important questions of what is Kubernetes and why use Kubernetes in your architecture. Okay, so before starting on the today's topic, let's don't forget to subscribe to our channel by pressing the bell icon to receive the notification directly in your inbox. And you can also subscribe to our email for getting the relevant updates directly delivered to your email boxes. Okay, so that being said, let's start on our today's topic and let's try to understand what exactly is Kubernetes and why we should consider using the Kubernetes. So here's an application architecture which basically runs on a virtual machine. Now this virtual server that we are talking about, this can be located in your cloud or even in your own data center. So basically this application can run anywhere. It is not specifically built for cloud or not specifically running in your data center. It can run anywhere. So the architecture of the application remains same wherever you are running this application. So the application basically consists of some UI. Okay, so this is the front end of the application and it's basically sending a request to the Nginx, which is in turn sending the request to the server and client, and there is a worker. So worker is responsible for all the backend processing that is being done for the application for the computation purpose. So whatever processing that the application would be receiving would be actually be performed by the worker. So if we talk about the scaling of this application, so what would be the desired scaling of this application should look like? So the desired scaling would be something like this, that we are having the Nginx and the server and client, which are basically responsible for sending out the request to the worker, and the worker is responsible for processing all the computation work. So what we want to scale, we just want to scale one component of this application, which is the worker, which is responsible for the computation purpose. So in an ideal world, we would want to scale only the worker. But let's say if we are running it on the EC2 instance, how this application was being scaled till now in a traditional kind of architecture. So the application would look like this. So basically the between the application and the backend comes a load balancer. Load balancer receives all the requests from the application for which the processing has to be done, and in turn send this request to the backend virtual servers. Now the, each virtual server will be having the complete set of application, including all the components of Nginx, server, client and worker. Now although the application itself, the Nginx, server and client could have handled the multiple workers itself, but up till now in a monolithic kind of application, you would find that if we have to scale out the application, we would actually deploy it on the multiple servers. And so that although we just wanted to scale out the workers, we have to scale out the other components as well. This is when you run your application in a traditional kind of architecture. Now this can comprise of your EC2 instances, your virtual servers that you are running in your own data center, or whether like using the services like Elastic Beanstalk. So your application is going to scale like this. Now this is not a very efficient scaling of the application. What would be the desired scaling should look like? The desired scaling should look like this. Instead of we scaling out the components like Nginx, server and client, we just going to scale out the components of worker. So we are going to create as many workers in the backend so that we are able to do as much processing in the computation on our application, so that the results are provided to the user much more quickly. The latency of the application is much lesser and we are able to better scale our application. Okay, so this will be our desired scaling, and this is what can be easily achieved with the help of the Kubernetes. The Kubernetes has been designed so that you can run each of the application in the form of a container, where your worker can run on a specific Docker container, and then you can scale out this container on the multiple instances, and only the worker is going to scale out in this case. So ideally, if you want to achieve this kind of scaling in a better optimized way, then you can you should go ahead and use the Kubernetes. And the Kubernetes architecture for this application would look like this. So you are going to have a virtual machine which is going to run your master. Basically, the master is in the Kubernetes is responsible for storing all your configuration requirements, which is maintaining the entire state of the cluster. Okay, and then you are having the multiple nodes in the backend. Like these nodes are basically responsible for running of your Kubernetes containers. Now, basically, whenever we talk about the containers, these Docker containers runs inside the Kubernetes pods, and these pods runs on the multiple nodes. So you can have as many nodes as you want, and the Kubernetes master is going to control all those nodes. So you can scale to indefinite number, and then you can have like multiple containers running on each node. There is no set number of containers that you can run on each node depending upon what are the physical resources that are available with the node, that is your memory and the CPU. You can create as many containers till the time it fulfills the requirement of the containers. So in this example, you will see that two containers are running on node one, one container is running on node two, and four containers are running on node three. So this can be an arbitrary, and Kubernetes will keep on spawning them and creating it on the different nodes depending upon the requirement. And so the architecture would look like this. The request from your application is going to come down to the load balancer, and the load balancer is going to distribute across the multiple nodes, and the master is controlling the overall state of your cluster. Now, whenever we talk about the Kubernetes cluster, it basically comprises of the master plus then all the nodes in the cluster. Okay, this is what the Kubernetes cluster forms, and master basically controls what each node does, okay, and where the containers are going to deploy. This is, there's a further scheduler responsible in the Kubernetes architecture for performing this, that where the container should be deployed. But this is how the architecture of the Kubernetes looks like. So to answer the initial questions that we discussed at the starting, like what is Kubernetes? So Kubernetes is basically it is a system for running the different containers over the multiple machines as a cluster. Okay, so you will going to run your application components over the different machine in the form of a cluster, which comprises of your master and the different nodes. And why use Kubernetes? If you are having an application which is having the multiple components and you want to run those components which are created from the multiple images on the different machines, then there is an ideal use of the Kubernetes. Ideally, Kubernetes is best suited for scaling out the microservices kind of architecture where different components forms your application. Okay, so this is all about the Kubernetes for this session. Stay tuned and subscribe, or don't forget to subscribe our channel to receive further updates on DevOps and Kubernetes. Thanks for listening to this session. See you in next session.